All right, so Mr. Tengren, I want to talk with him. All right, let's talk to my uncle, Duncan.
Duncan.
Yes, my lord.
I have much to consider and face a difficult decision.
Perhaps I can help. Your father often sought my counsel.
Yeah, let's ask about that.
As lord, I must name a sentinel.
Of course. And if I may ask, who do you favor for the role? Perhaps I can share my insight. And talking can sometimes help you make a decision.
What do you think of Sir Roiland? Do you trust him?
He's a fine warrior, my lord. But he's nowhere near ready to serve a sentinel. I do not trust him. He's likely to lose his temper and get us all killed. And at the worst possible time.
Thank you, Duncan. I appreciate your advice.
I'm at your service, my lord.
Alright, well, I don't trust him either. He's way too nice, let's be honest. This is Game of Thrones. Alright, can I talk to my sister? Hey. What's going on? Malcolm. Who the hell is Malcolm?
Ethan. Or should I say Lord Ethan?
Hello, Uncle Malcolm.
I saw what you did today. It's not an easy thing to do, dealing out a harsh punishment, no matter how warranted. But if you'll excuse me, my lord, I should finish packing before nightfall. I hope to be off tomorrow.
Where are you going?
But where are you going?
Your mother asked me to cross the narrow sea to find your brother, Asher.
Asher?
She has asked me to return with him. To help the house.
She said nothing of this to me.
Because she fears you will not agree. I told her my place is here, that I'll be of no help to you in Essos. But she insisted. I will hold, of course, until you've spoken with her about this. Just try to be kind to her. She's been living a nightmare made real. But you know that just as well.
I'll be gentle.
She's my mother. Of course I'll be gentle.
I know you will. You're good-hearted, my lord. That is your true strength.
But my mother's fears are not the only ones I face. My people are scared as well. I'm told I must choose a sentinel.
If I may be so bold, Sir Roiland is the man for the job. He'd be a fine choice.
But
trust him.
Why do you say that?
Aye. Sir Roiland is the man you want.
Why Sir Roiland?
We are at war. You need a warrior by your side. Roiland has the respect of his men and will bring strength and discipline to this house. Duncan would offer sage advice, but now is not the time to negotiate. Not with the likes of Ramsay Snow.
Thank you, Uncle.
Ethan, I need to talk to you.
Oh, now you want my attention. Maybe she wants to become Sentinel.
I saw what you did to that man. The way you punished him. How could you be so cruel?
Hey, that's not cruel.
I'm worried about you.
You left me no choice.
What am I supposed to think?
I did what I had to. I had no choice.
You always have choices.
Not in this game.
I know you told me you'd have to change, but I suppose I hadn't believed you would.
I can't afford any more mistakes. Everyone knows what happened with Lord Whitehill. Garrod being sent to the war without my knowledge.
I know. And that wasn't your fault.
Well, I'm the Lord. It's my responsibility. The people want me to lead. They need me to, but...
What? Ethan,
who
please.
Should be Sentinel?
Tell me.
Who should I name as my Sentinel?
It should definitely be Duncan Tuttle. He's dependable and smart, and everyone trusts his judgment. Sir Roiland is unpredictable and likely to make matters worse.
You've always given me good advice. Thank you.
Alright, so I'm pretty sure almost everybody will go with Duncan as their sentinel. So, I'm gonna go with the interesting choice and probably give it to Roiland here. What's up, man?
Sword up! Swing left! Parry! Wrong! I didn't know dogs could hold swords.
A word?
Of course, my lord.
I have many decisions to make. and I wanted your advice.
I need a sentinel.
I need to name a sentinel.
Ah, you do. And it's good you came to me. I know this house, and everyone here knows me. They know I can hold the reins, or wield the sword in equal measure. I'm the man you need. And might I remind you, it was Duncan Tuttle who sent Garin to the wall. He undermined your authority and made you look weak to the White Hills. I would never do that to you. And if you pardon me saying so, I think your father would be proud.
Your words are wise.
Seeing you make good choices as a young lord.
Your words are wise, Sir Roiland.
Thank you, my lord.
I will consider them as I make my choice.
So, when will you declare your decision, my lord?
Tonight, at the small council meeting.
Very good. I trust your judgment, my lord.
All right. I feel like Telltale is trying really hard to make this guy not very likable. I could give a bracer now, but I think it would be best to wait for the meeting. So I'll speak with that old weird guy with the chain. And here you go. What's up, man? Or Tengrin, that's his name. Look at food. Speak with man. All right, let's go.
Slash right.
Maester.
Yes, Lord Ethan. I see you've spoken to a number of people. Are you prepared to name your sentinel?
What is your perspective? Not yet. Yes, I am. I am. Yeah, let's do it.
Yes, Maester. I'm ready.
Very well. I will convene the small council at once.
This is the moment of truth. I very much wonder how this will play out during the rest of the game, because it does seem like a pretty big decision, you know, pick a right-hand man and all that.
You may sit.
I believe Lord Ethan has reached his decision.
Before I name my sentinel, I must tell you.
You are both worthy. Let's go with that.
Duncan, Roiland, this house needs you both.
But you can only choose one, my lord.
I know that.
Let me be on with it.
Many thought either of you would make a fine sentinel, but I have made my decision.
I'm picking my mother. Alright, I'm going with Roiland. I made up my mind. Let's do it.
Sir Roiland de Gore, you will be my sentinel.
Gods be praised. You've done well, Lord Ethan. You won't regret this.
A poor choice, my lord. Forgive me for saying so, but it's true.
Hey. Don't be a jerk.
Now, sentinel, what do you have to report of Ramsay Snow?
My scouts say he's a day's ride away. We've no time to waste. He'll arrive before any of our allies could be here.
Who knows what he's capable of? We need to prepare for the worst.
Don't panic.
There's no need to panic. We can devise a plan to deal with him.
The Boltons need our people to harvest the ironwood. Even the bastard Ramsay must understand that.
He's not coming here to negotiate. We must answer with the sword.
That's bloody suicide. You gamble with the lives of everyone within these walls.
Quiet, Tuttle. You're not the sentinel. I knew this would happen. He cannot be trusted.
This
hey,
is
stop
the
bickering.
Small council, is it not?
Enough! Would my father have stood for this kind of bickering? Neither will I.
The Bolton sigil is a flayed man. Force is the only thing they understand. Put every man who can hold a spear or crossbow on the wall, and make the bastard fill his boots with piss.
He would see it for the empty gesture that it is, and have us flayed. We must take a measured approach, my lord.
Gentlemen, please.
What do you reckon? We must be unified. I'll go with that. That seems good.
We all must agree on the plan. We cannot leave until we have a consensus.
Ugh.
Why not make an offering for peace, my lord?
Yeah, the wisdom of the Citadel.
We can give the Boltons ironwood in exchange for their protection.
You must be mad. It's pure folly to just give away the only currency we have to bargain with.
Enough!
We will bargain, we will use diplomacy, we will fight. Fighting is a terrible idea, that won't work. Diplomacy, I feel, will also not work with these douchebags, so I will bargain.
Maester Ortengren has swayed me. We will offer the Boltons a share of the ironwood, and we will promise our people to harvest it, thus securing their safety.
A sentinel, I must warn you. Do this, and you invite ruin upon this house.
If we don't, there may be no House Forester at all.
If you aren't ready for a fight, you're bound to lose when one breaks out.
Ethan has made his opinion known, and you will respect his decision.
Forgive us, my lord. We are, of course, here to serve you, as we served your father.
Aye.
Well then, let's decide how we shall set the stage for Ramsay's arrival.
We could offer him the ironwood in the courtyard.
My lord, making this kind of offer outright may simply embolden Ramsay. There could be trouble, and all the house will be there to see it. Meet him in the hall. It will be more private, and he will not have an audience to play against you.
Lord Ethan?
Well, I mean, I agree with that. Let's get him into the Great Hall.
I will meet him in the Great Hall.
It's careless. Can't you see Tuttle is steering you wrong? I've faithfully served this house for far too long to sit here and listen to this. Forgive me, my lord, but you are far too young to be the lord of this house.
Why are you
You're
a jerk?
You're likely to get us all killed.
Sit down.
Sit down at once.
Apologies, my son. But now that it is settled, we know what we must do. You will meet Ramsay Snow in the Great Hall.
And we will offer the ironwood, providing a safe future for this house.
No matter what, I will stand beside you, my lord, where your sentinel belongs.
Thanks, man.
And perhaps we should adjourn. We have to prepare the house.
My lord, you have named your sentinel, but you still seem conflicted. And no matter what, you can't be indecisive. Not if you want to help this house. Forgive me.
There will always be those who question your leadership, which is why you need allies you can rely on. Family. What about your brother, Asher?
Oh, here we go.
Malcolm told me. You want to bring him back?
He's a skilled fighter. But what's more, he has the will to fight, a hunger for it. He always protected you and your sister.
But do you want him to be a lord?
And we need all the help we can get.
But won't he be lord if he returns? Do you want him to take my place?
Of course not. He has no interest in such things. And that's not what I want either. Asher is volatile, but that is his strength too. Do you remember the miller's boy? How he tormented you. I wanted to intervene, but your father said Ethan must fight his own battles. But when Asher saw it, he didn't take a breath. He grabbed the miller's boy by the neck. That was his first instinct. Asher knocked out half the poor boy's teeth. Of course, your father was furious, but you were in danger and there was nothing else Asher needed to know. Asher does not hesitate. He acts, and we need that. You have many fine qualities. But you do not have that anger inside
He's
you.
He's dangerous.
It's something we could use.
Asher is dangerous and unpredictable. His presence could help or hurt.
Having another sword at your side always helps, especially now. I'm trying to do what's best for this family, what this family needs. Ethan, let me send Malcolm to Essos.
Yeah, I do want to meet this Asher guy, so let's send him.
Fine. Malcolm will go to Essos and bring Asher back.
Thank you, Ethan. I'm glad you will let me do this. Know that you never stand alone. You are a forester. Mira stands with us, and she may be able to help us yet.
Yeah, that would be pretty nice. All right, what's going on? Is the game just freezing or what? Come on, okay. Jesus Christ, that took a long time.
M'lady.
You.
It's the street rat.
Begging your pardon, m'lady.
How long have you been there? Who is this guy?
How long have you been waiting there?
Not long. I was just passing by when I saw you emerge from Lady Marjorie's room. I just want you to know, I can help you if you'd like, and your family, if you're willing to trust me. I hear all sorts of things, that could be useful for you.
How?
How can you help me? My problems can't be solved by what you might overhear.
Which is why you must trust me, m'lady. You need allies.
I'm sorry, I really must go.
Please don't despair. I know people who...
What is it?
People who'd be willing to help you.
It's just a random guard. Well, is he checking me out? That's not okay. Dirty, dirty man.
Where the bloody hell is Duncan? He should be here. Ah, fuck him if he's hungry. We'll do without him. And without King's Landing. I know you'd hoped Mira could help us, but I'm confident we've enough strength of our own. Your men are ready to act if needed.
Don't do anything crazy, dude.
Sir Roiland, I trust you'll keep a level head.
Of course, my lord. But the bastard of Bolton can't be trusted to do the same.
Oh no, it's this guy again.
Isn't this a lovely pile of timber? Not the place I'd want to be if there was a fire.
Ironwood is near impervious to flame, my lord.
Is it?
May I introduce Lord Ramsay of House Bolton, son of Roos Bolton? Although a bastard, Lord Ramsay has the full authority of the
Thank
Warden
you.
Of
no,
the...
That's enough. Who is this little boy? Is he lost?
Shall we begin?
Lord Ramsay, shall we begin? We do not wish to waste your time.
I'm afraid it's too late for that. Aren't you the little lord? Lord Whitehall told me you were young, but this... Look at you.
A token for the new Warden of the North.
Let me guess. Forester Ironwood.
Carved by our most skilled craftsman.
Ironwood. Doesn't look like much.
No one can match our skill.
Don't know what's so special about it.
No one can match our skill.
Is that so?
See, it's pretty good.
Not bad. Lord Whitehill, can your lot do this?
Given enough time, we could learn...
Given enough time, you could do a great many things. But not this, apparently. It seems the foresters have a talent for something after all.
I'm not saying anything.
Lord Ramsay, we have another gift we'd like to offer your father. There are several ironwood groves along the borders of our land, all producing tall, strong trees. We'd like to give your father two of these groves, in tribute.
Give him? He is your warden. What's yours is already his. Look at that. More foresters.
Lord Ramsay.
Come out where I can see you.
Force him to focus on the business at hand.
Leave them be? I don't know.
Leave them be, Lord Ramsay.
I didn't...
Worried about your family.
As I you guess said, it worked out in the end.
I'm the Lord. I'll have you speak only with me.
First, let's see you bend the knee to my father. Lord Bolton, Warden of the North. Words are wind. Anyone can say they're loyal.
All right, I'll do it.
Show me.
My lord.
Ha! That wasn't so hard now, was it? Here's the thing. I don't care about your loyalty. And I care even less about a bunch of trees on some far-off hill. The Crown, however, wants what you've got. Whatever you've been supplying the Starks for centuries. Ships, shields, chamber pots. I expect you'll do the same for us. My father has promised as much to the king. You wouldn't want to make him a liar, would you? That wouldn't reflect well on me.
We will double our efforts.
We will double our efforts for your father, my lord.
That's a good little lord.
You can't trust a forester. They murdered our men.
It was a forester squire who did it. One Whitehill soldier dead. One Bolton.
He was justified.
Yet
yeah, I'll go with that.
Your man lived.
He was within his right. They killed his family.
His right? He killed a loyal soldier in my father's army. Then you welcomed me into your hall like a proper lord, hoping I wouldn't linger outside long enough to notice your pathetic little army. That sort of insolence from one of our loyal bannermen will not do. So I've come up with a solution that will benefit everyone. The Whitehills will be taking control of your ironwood from this day forward.
What?
What? The ironwood? But...
The Whitehills are nothing more than up-jump thieves!
You can't do that!
Why not? You know something the Whitehills don't? We are talking about trees. You grow them, you cut them down.
We are the true craftsmen.
It can't be that difficult.
We have loyal craftsmen who make the finest weapons. The Whitehills have no such craftsmen. Do you want ironwood for the next 5 years, or the next 50 generations?
The little lord does have a point.
Yeah, I do.
We'll try this. Lord Whitehill will take half of your ironwood, and we'll see who fares better.
But my lord...
Half of something is better than the nothing you had before. To ensure there's no trouble, Lord Whitehill will install a garrison of 20 men within your walls.
At Ironwrath, that we cannot abide. Ethan.
They'll help maintain the king's peace. And make sure there's no more trouble.
I guess we have no choice but to take the offer, I mean...
You have a man you trust?
My son. Griff.
Riff. We'll lead the garrison.
The seven hells he will.
Lads, do make this visit worthwhile.
Please, Sir Roiland, don't.
Look at this little forester. You're not frightened, are you?
Hey, that's just a little kid.
Lord Ramsay, please.
And you? Are you Lord Ethan's older sister?
I'm his twin, my lord.
Oh, twins. Like the queen and her brother. Well, hopefully not just like the queen and her brother.
No, that would be messed up.
I never had a sister. Always wanted one.
We have more to discuss. Leave them be. Enough.
Enough, Lord Snow.
I have an idea. You'll come with me.
No, that's
you
a bad idea.
Highborn ward.
Lord Ramsay, that's enough.
Do you like hunting?
Let her go.
She's quite pretty, your sister.
Take me instead.
We'd get along well.
Greb.
I suppose you can stay.
Oh, I did it.
Aren't you the bold lord?
Wait, what?
What have you done?
But I don't want a bold lord.
I wasn't expecting that to happen. Oh, shit.
My lord!
No, no!
Even though you did bend the knee. I think we've come to an understanding.
Ethan!
I certainly feel better about all this.
Ethan! No,
however, the foresters need to keep their end of the bargain.
Stop!
Ryan!
Take the boy as your ward.
No!
Kill him if they give you any trouble.
Ryan!
Lovely meeting all of you.
Well, I wasn't expecting
we'll
that.
Again sometime.
Somebody help him!
Fetch the mace quickly!
You brought this on yourself.
Mama!
Please. Stop!
Don't let him take me!
You will not take
Stop
him!
No, please! Ryan, please!
No!
No! Ryan!
Do something!
Ethan?
Yeah, that guy's dead. Jesus Christ, alright. I guess I messed up somewhere. Your story has begun. Next time on Game of Thrones.
Ethan sacrificed himself for us all. He saved Talia's life. He'll be remembered as Ethan the Brave.
This house needs a leader.
Lord Ethan named me Sentinel. I will lead this house.
My sister asked you to swear loyalty to her son, and you flat out refused.
We can't let them hurt Ryan too. We have to stop them.
We do not stand alone. There are those who will fight for us. Those who hold House Forrester above all other loyalties.
Jon Snow.
Those who will not stop until Ethan is avenged. Until Ryan is home again, our house will not fall. We will be ready.
Nothing comes without a cost, my lady. Are you prepared for what might happen?
Oh, God. All right, let's see. Wow, okay, I made some very unpopular choices here. All right, so I stay with Bowen. That was sort of all right. Pretty much no one swore loyalty to Marjorie. Only 19% of people took the guy's fingers. 39% of people picked Roiland as Sentinel. That's what I thought. And most people did choose to meet Ramsay in the Great Hall because, let's be honest, that was the most logical choice, I think. So, okay, yeah. God. What in the world? All right, so continue. I guess that's the ending. Yep, that was the... Oh, oops. Okay, that was the ending. No, thank you. All right, so now the wait begins for episode 2, and then we will finally meet Asher. I hope there's another character out there who we can probably play as, but we don't know who it is. Man, that was a good ending. That was a good ending. I wasn't expecting that. So good job on that. Although I did think Ethan wasn't like the best character, so it made sense for them to kill him off like that. That was pretty good. Anyway, I'm very excited to see episode 2. I hope you guys enjoyed the first episode. If you did, please let me know what you thought about it. Or if you didn't enjoy it, let me know what you thought about it as well. Just, you know, leave a comment. Tell me what you think of the episode. I thought it was pretty good. I saw a lot of reviews and a lot of them were quite bad, but I thought it was pretty good. Probably because I'm really into Game of Thrones, so it really did feel fitting. You know, the stuff at King's Landing, where the stupid little diplomacy is really important and all that. I thought it was pretty awesome. So let me know what you thought about it, and I will talk to you guys later. Thanks for watching, guys.